Hello everyone. Welcome to the 33rd video of the Adobe After Effects tutorial from beginner to advanced. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, I recommend that you do. Channel effects affect the color channels of the film, which we examine in this video. I have two images in the layers panel. Now I go to the effects panel and add the arithmetic effect to the layer. By adding the arithmetic effect, we can change the amount of red, green, and blue channels separately. Changing the value of each color channel affects the color of the footage. Also, by changing the type of operator, the effect of color channels on pixels will be different. To return the effect to the default state, click on the reset option. I delete this effect and add the blend effect to the layer. The blend effect combines two layers together. First, I select the name of the layer that I want to combine with this layer. Now, by reducing the blend with original option, I adjust the amount of blending of the footages. As a result, the upper layer is combined with the lower layer. We can also change the mode. By default, crossfade is selected, which makes the original image fade. Color only colors each pixel in the original image based on the pixel color in the second image. Tint only is similar to color only, but only tints pixels in the original image if they are already tinted. Darken makes the pixels in the original image darker than the corresponding pixel in the second image. Lighten makes pixels in the original image brighter than the corresponding pixel in the second image. If the size of the combined layers is different, activating this option will make them proportional. Now, to apply the effect to only a part of the image, I select the bottom layer and mask an area with the shape tool. I go back to the top layer, and instead of the source option, I choose the masks option. We can change the mode again. I delete this effect and the bottom layer mask and add the calculation effect to the layer. The calculation effect combines the channels of one layer with the channels of the second layer. In the input channel, the RGBA option displays all channels normally. But by choosing gray, red, blue, and green options, we will have a black and white image. I choose RGBA again. Create an X-ray image by activating Invert input. Now I select the second layer to blend with the main layer, and I change the opacity value of the second layer to 50% so that every two layers are blended together. Now we can also change the blending mode. In this way, you can get different combinations of images. By activating this option, I invert the second layer. You can also change the channel of the second layer. To show how to use the preserve transparency option, I will add a layer. I make the bird image smaller and hide the second layer. Now I will apply the calculation effect to the bird layer and add the nature layer. I also change the opacity value of the second layer to 50% so that every two layers are combined together. Now you can see that deactivating preserve transparency causes the transparency of the bird layer to disappear. I delete the bird layer and go to another composition to show how to use the CC composite effect. After that, I type a text. The CC composite effect is used to combine the original layer with the added effects in a part of the image. I place the text in the center and create a mask. Now, from the effects panel, I add the CC composite effect to the layer. By clicking on the RGB option, we can see the text in full. I put the effect on the screen and change the opacity of the text. Now I add the hue effect to the layer and move the CC composite effect down. Now I can change the color of the masked part of the text by changing hue. Returning to the previous composition, I add the channel combiner effect to the layer, and as the name suggests, it is used to combine color channels. In the From option, we must select the title of the entry. I choose red. With the To option, we select the channel on which red should be applied. You can see the effect of different channels on the footage. The Invert option also inverts the channels. We can also select and combine another layer and see its effect on the footage. For 2, I choose Lightness mode to create an interesting combination of two layers. I delete this effect and add the compound arithmetic effect to the layer. The compound arithmetic effect is similar to the previous effects. We select the second layer and determine the type of operator. Also, Blend with Original shows the transparency of the effect and the amount of blending layers. Enable this option to adjust the size of the second image to the first image. I delete this effect and add the Invert effect to the layer. The Invert effect, which is one of the channel effects in After Effects, inverts the color information of an image. The Channel option indicates which channel or channels the effect will invert. Choosing each channel will have a different result. Adjust the amount of the effect by changing Blend with Original. I delete this effect and add the Minimax effect to the layer. The Minimax effect assigns to each channel of a pixel the minimum or maximum value for that channel within a specified radius. I increase the radius value to make the pixels bigger. This effect can be used to enlarge or reduce the opacity of the image. Also, using the Channel option, we can determine whether the effect is applied to colors or a color channel. The Direction option is the axis along which the values are scanned. Horizontal and Vertical option scans all directions. I change the operator to minimum to see its effect on the image. I go to another composition to check the Remove Color Matting effect. In this image, I remove the green background using the Keylight effect. I will teach this effect in future lessons. Now I zoom in a bit, you can see that due to removing the background, a white color is placed on the edges. We usually use the Remove Color Matting effect to remove these extra edges. So I add the Remove Color Matting effect to the layer. Now I change the color to white. In this way you can see that the white edges are removed. You can see the effect of changes by activating and deactivating. I go back to the previous composition and add the Set Channels effect to the layer. The Set Channels effect copies channels from the original layer to the red, green, blue, and alpha channels of the effect. For example, for the blue color, I select the desired layer. In this way, the blue colors of the bottom image are transferred to the image of the top layer. To teach the next effect, I go to another composition and draw a shape. I change its color to red. I also create a text layer. I make the text smaller and its color white. Now I add the Set Matte effect to the text layer. In the Take Matte from Layer option, I select the desired layer. In this way, we can see the text only in the place where this shape exists. By activating this option, the matte will be reversed. In fact, now the text is only visible inside the shape. We can also choose other color channels for the text. This effect is used a lot in animation. I delete this effect and return to the previous composition. I add the shift channels effect to the layer. The shift channels effect replaces the red, green, blue, and alpha channels in the image with the values of the other channels. For example, I replace green with red. Or I choose hue. Replacing each channel will change and combine the images. I delete this effect and add a photo in the new composition. I click the transparency option. You can see that this photo has no background. Now I add the solid composite effect to the layer. In this way, a white background or solid is added to the image. We can change the background color. Also, in the settings of this effect, we can reduce the opacity of the background or the main image. I change the blending mode to create different results in the image. Well guys, thank you so much for watching this tutorial till the end. In the next video, I will teach you the continuation of the effects. Please like the video and leave a comment for me. Subscribe to see more tutorials. See you next time.